Russell Mora is telling Kingsley Ibe, you got to show me something. He's thinking about stopping the fight with the damage Ibe is taking. Big guy, former football player, 6'4", 276, and he's absorbing a lot of punishment. And a big left hand will end the night. Jared Anderson, 8-for-8, explosive finish.
He's still out, Joe. He's still out.
Hurt bad. You know, Anderson being very smart right there, feigning before he actually attacked. Nice block right there and came back with offense and caught him with a nice, beautiful short left hook in the inside, right on the chin. Ibe was pretty much ready to go, you know, and we said early on that he had to get a little more consistent with his offense, and if he gets a little bit more consistent with his offense, he could get the stoppage.
Yeah, he closed the show just like we said, and you can see in the eyes of Ibe that he was ready to go, but, you know, he's been around the game long enough to know how to survive, and Anderson didn't give him that opportunity. A great step back, beautiful right hand to the top of the head, and a left hook that literally turned the lights out of Ibe. That was the Sports Center type 10 shot, top 10 shot that we were talking about.
Oh, you are going to see that everywhere.
He may not get up, and if he does, he's going to be in no condition to continue. This fight is over. Zilei Zhang proves that the first time was not a fluke. And this is how it ends.
And what did I say?
Watch that right hook.
Watch the right hook. The right hook is going to be coming.
Textbook shot.
Look at, oh my gosh. Oh, he caught him as he was getting ready to throw the right hand. As Joyce was getting ready to throw his right hand, he caught him right in between, you know, not moving your head, being able to take shots. And I use this analogy a lot. You know, it's like chipping away at a rock, little by little. Sooner or later, that rock is gonna crack right open.
He did
it. That's what you saw today.
Joseph Parker, Carlos Takam, Daniel Dubois, Brian Jennings, he took shots from Berman Stavern, and tonight that accumulation came to bear with one perfectly thrown, turned over and connected right hand on the chin that had been tested but had never been put down like it was tonight, and it was a vicious finish.
Wilder just coasting back into that neutral corner, and now Fury's looking to split the guard as Wilder's in bad shape. This fight is over. This TKO victory. There is only one. There is only one. Crown the king, the lone undefeated heavyweight champion of the world.
Deontay Wilder was taking a lot of punishment. It was just a matter of time before Tyson Fury landed that shot right there. Stood Deontay Wilder up. He's taking a lot of punishment. That was a good stoppage by the corner. They did the right thing. They showed mercy. Deontay Wilder was getting ready to be knocked out.
And here you see it. You don't just go back in the corner and hold up your hands and stay there because you're an open target. And Tyson Fury seen that, and he just came, rushed ahead with his killer instinct, just with a barrage of punches, ended it.
But to Wilder's credit, he didn't quit, and he wasn't looking for a way out.
Fury lands. He throws, but he uses some of his forearm with it. He throws the right.
That was clean.
Oh, that was clean,
that
yeah.
Was clean,
but there was, I mean, backwards. I meant a little bit going backwards, but bang.
Oh, my God.
That's a highlight reel.
Woo! What a highlight knockout. Reel. We're going to see that on the loop for quite some time.